What utter foolishness.
What is wrong?
I died. And you will help me.
Of course, Gunhild. But to what end?
When the Einherjar came, we needed a way to fight back. I suggested it. Say them, Major.
I understand your desperation, but that was foolish.
Clearly. I was lucky enough to be murdered before my mind could be corrupted. You must...
Of course. Say their magic corrupts so ruthlessly. Those poor souls must be in agony.
Then we shall give them death.
How do we get up there, I wonder?
We can't. Not with those vines in the way.
Like more of Lunda's old armor. Nearly have the complete set now.
Must be Sather this way. We'll need to find another way around.
Anything illuminating?
You got some slag from the homeland, huh? Hand it over, I'll fix you up something.
Waterfalls. We're close. There should be a gate up ahead.
That's quite a gate. Don't suppose you know a way through.
The Pilgrim Gate. I can open it. We just need to find the right vantage point.
Freya, there's something I've always wanted to ask. What was it Hrimthor whispered to you?
Who?
Hrimthor, the son of Thormur, the stonemason, who disguised himself and built Asgard's wall.
Oh, yes. One of the many occasions Odin saw fit to involve me in a wager without my consent. I wish I could say that was the worst of his husbandly habits.
What wager?
I've told this story, brother.
And now she may tell her own.
There isn't that... ...much to tell. I knew nothing of it at first, surely because Odin didn't expect to lose the bet. A mysterious mason had to build the entire wall in 3 turns of the season.
Two! It was 2!
And if he was late, he'd be owed nothing. But if he succeeded, he was promised an audience with the queen. Or so I learned one day when Odin burst into our bedchambers, raging and half-drunk before noon, telling me to get dressed and go see what the mason wants. So, off I went. Not knowing what had truly been promised or expected. Dagger stashed in my robe for emergency. And this mason, this giant in disguise.
His name was Hrimthor.
He just smiled to see me. And as you said, he whispered in my ear. He said the Aesir had killed his father. And he needed to know that one day they'd burn for it. I pointed out I was Aesir now too, technically. He gave me a look, as if he somehow knew better, and continued. He said he'd built in a structural flaw behind the Asgard Realm Tower.
I knew it! How do we make use of it?
We don't. He said Surtur would know what to do. And if Surtur's approaching Asgard's wall...
Then it is already Ragnarok.
Blast it. I hoped it might have given us another way.
Freya, something your brother said. The Aesir burned him.
Yes. We weren't yet at war, but relations with the Vanir and Aesir had been hostile for ages. Freyr got it into his head that he could improve relations by sharing our magic with them. Vanir techniques for bountiful harvests, enough to feed their whole population.
Ah, but enough of that for now.
despite his actions in Midgard, Atreus does still care for you.
I know. I raised a son, too. It may be hard to believe, but he was quite similar to Atreus at this age. He adored his father, always wanted to do right by him, and was constantly frustrated that no matter what he did, he never could seem to get his approval. He confided in me a lot, sought the comfort his father withheld. I wonder if your son could benefit from that too.
He has befriended the other dwarf. The Blue One's brother.
Oh. Well, if Sindri has that covered, I suppose there's no need for me in his life anymore, is there?
That is not what I meant.
That was sarcasm. Sigil arrows won't work on this.
Find that orb yet?
This crest. It's mine. Mimir, I never asked how it felt. Lose your head.
What would you have me say? That it tickled?
Merely curious.
If you wish to derive some satisfaction from my pain, I'm afraid you'll be disappointed. Kratos swung swift and true, didn't you, brother? I felt nearly a scratch.
Shame.
Thank you.
There. I see the chalice.
From the ceremony.
A symbol of reconciliation. We drank from the lover's chalice until we could hardly stand. I confided in him that night about wanting an apology from Freyr. Odin reassured me that he'd be the only family I'd meet. And I believed him. It's a denouncement from my people, placed during my wedding.
Anything illuminating?
The word is complete, but I still can't read it from here. Let's head back down.
Better now?
No. The pain only grew. Will I never be free of it? What more do I need to do? Side of this door scare me most.
The most difficult battles are fought within, but this battle, you will not fight alone. Are you ready?
Yes. There it is. My final tie to Asgard. We drove that sword into the pillar together. The sword was forged for the ceremony. A symbol of our union. Molna.
The stone refuses to let go.
The deepest wounds form the strongest bonds. Bastard said it as part of our vows. I hate it when he's right. Asgard holds a part of me I can't sever. My bond to my son. To the Valkyries. That damn realm isn't just Odin's. It belongs to me, too. The pain he caused is his. I refuse to keep holding on to it. This sword no longer holds our legacy. But it will serve as mine.
A much more fitting use for it.
Learn anything?
I suppose it's on to the next battle now.
Yes. You won an important one today. Go!
I suppose it's on to the next battle now.
Yes. You won an important one today.
I suppose it's on to the next battle now.
Yes. You won an important one today.
Wolver! Left leg!
If I may.
Since when have you ever asked for permission?
It's just... I owe you my life, such as it is. And I caused you so much pain, put you in a terrible situation. For that, Freya, I'm truly sorry.
I wanted to end that war too.
I know. I swear to do better by you nonetheless. Anything you ask, consider it done. I'm forever in your debt.
I appreciate that. Even if you can't help being an obnoxious know-it-all.
I'm afraid I'll never know how to stop doing that, Your Majesty. Much for that boat.
You know, an arrogant man once told me you can't change the past, only how it shapes you. I think he might be right. It's been a while since I've had a confidant. Would the god of few words lend me his ear now and again?
As long as I am needed.
Well, lady, I was curious about some of the flora we've encountered on our travels.
And you will remain curious. It's not my job to teach you everything, Lemire.
Look, I was just asking.
And you have been told.
Oh, you can say that again.
That Lunda's armor? Hand it over. I can fix it up right quick.
And how is it you two know each other?
Nah, I can't be divulger in guild business. You gotta respect the secretude of it all.
I'm sorry?
Let's just say Brock and I have long enjoyed certain common interests.
That's right. Like getting us into trouble.
And getting you back out of it again.
What? That's only mostly true.
Okay, so does that answer your question?
Close enough.
Family crests? I'll take them. Somebody ought to save these, even if the Vanir won't.
What is this?
Ravens. The ones we've been destroying. Odin's little spies.
Like the father of all, we swung from the tree. Wisdom gained father, servitude gained we.
Swung from the tree.
What do you suppose that means?
In life we hanged, in death we kneeled. Until you freed us with your steel.
So destroying the ravens freed their spirit somehow. Good to know.
Free.
Well, free of Odin's control anyway.
Thank you.
Are we off to find that elven sanctum then, or something else?
We certainly can. Though we do have something else that needs our attention.
Last we were in Alfheim, Atreus heard something out in the Barrens. A creature in terrible pain. And what else? There's still that secret elven library in Alfheim.
Lead the way.
Creature Atreus heard. It lies out in the desert.
Wonder what it could be. Most of the larger beasts of Alfheim have long been dead.
I'm sure my brother would know. He loved this realm.
And the realm loved him in turn. Still does.
I'm sure he blames me for having to leave.
That was not your fault.
I know that. But I can't fault him for wanting to protect his family, even at the cost of plunging this realm back into war.
We should be able to reach the Barrens up top, once we find a way past this hive matter.
What are these tendrils?
Part of the Dark Elf Hive.
Far distant from the hive I remember as a child.
Alfheim's changed a great deal since then.
I suppose we all have.